Hello, I'm Russell Sherwood. I wanted to show you my Glasair that's powered by a Subaru EG33 engine. We have a reduction drive that's built by Mark Hott, and that drives an MT three-blade propeller. Now, I've been having a little bit of gear wear with the Mark Hott, and what's happening, this is a gear from the Mark Hott, a ring gear here, and then the propeller end over here. It sits about here. And I think what may be happening is I'm getting some torsional vibration, and these two gears are rattling in there and creating some wear. And so you won't be able to see it, I'm sure, but there's some spline wear on there that I'd like to get rid of. And so I found a company in Houston that can do a torsional survey here, and what they needed was a flywheel that has these 80 teeth cut in here. So there'll be a sensor, and here's my dummy sensor that I made so I can align everything, but it'll be sitting about here, and as the flywheel runs around, that sensor will pick up the time between tooth one, tooth two, tooth three, and so on, and measure the difference in the time. So it's telling how quickly the flywheel is speeding up or slowing down. Normally, that speeding up and slowing down is a fairly slow action. If you have torsional vibration, it starts to ring or vibrate. And so these changes in time will be a lot larger than they're normal. So the company can show me or tell me that, hey, maybe at a particular RPM I should avoid, because that's where the problems start showing up. Here is another view of my Glasair 1RG. You can see the Subaru EG33 engine, and we have mounted the Mark Hott gearbox and MT prop. I wanted to show a metal bracket to hold the timing sensor. And the sensor will screw into this hole, looking at these teeth on the flywheel. Okay, Dustin's here, and he's just installed the sensor.
This one is going to be our tachometer. This has 80 pulses per rev.
The test flight for the Glasair has been completed, and we have the test results back. And we have several pages in here. There are graphs in here and an explanation on each graph of what was going on. Bottom line, we didn't find anything that's doing any damage, any torsional vibration that's doing any damage. There were three momentary peaks that were probably from an engine miss. It was unrelated to RPM or power. And so it's good to find out that we have no damage being done by torsional vibration.